Good morning to my fellow Bubble Clash players. In this video I'm going to show you how to get up to 30, 40, 50,000 points in just 4 easy steps. It's all very simple. Now, a little disclaimer here, this will take time and practice. It's not going to be a lot of time, but it's at least going to be a day of like playing. And this will increase your skill ceiling. So the way Bubble Clash works is there's an algorithm that sorts your skill level to put against players who also have that similar skill level. So once you apply these strategies, you will be playing against other players who are just as good, and they'll get consistently 20,000 to 28,000 every gem game, and for money games they'll at least get 40 to 30,000. So just a warning here guys, please just don't spam these strategies and use them wisely as to not raise your skill level too high and get as much profit from it as possible. Now before we get into the video, please do use my promo code so that I get a dollar and you'll get a dollar, and then you can play rookie games and actually watch my other video on how to maximize profits with money or gems. There's multiple videos, I'll link down below, after finishing this one of course. And to jump straight into the video, for the step one is to clear the board in the fastest time possible. Now there's not much strategy to this, but all you gotta do is clear the board as fast as possible just playing regular Bubble Clash, and I have a link on the video on how to play Bubble Clash to help you with clearing the board, but it's just practice, practice, practice. Now, do give a little warning, for it's better to get, if you want to get to 50 to 60,000 points, it's better to finish clearing the board before the 2-minute mark, otherwise it's going to be almost too impossible to do it. And if you finish at 1 minute 40, it's already only going to be 40,000 to 38,000, you know, it depends on your skill level. And if you finish within a minute clearing the board, all you'll have is only 20,000 to 23,000 if you're good. Now step 2 is stacking the balls on the corners and the middle without breaking a single pair. Now you've probably seen other people do this. If you look up how to like play Bubble Clash, there's other videos on this, and that's the strategy that gets you the most point, is the stacking of the stacking of the bubbles on the corners. Now what they actually don't do is they start, sometimes they break the corners, which actually wastes them time. Now the best way to apply it is to stack it without breaking any bubbles, to waste the hearts as fast as possible, because the goal of it is to make the wall bigger as fast as possible, because in this case time is points, and thus by breaking a pair you're not losing a heart, and thus you're not building up that wall fast enough, you're just wasting time. So try to go for these stacks without breaking a single pair, getting it as high as possible and then destroying it all. Now step 3 is start breaking the bubbles on the sides, leaving only a few. Now this is what I like to do, it's just a safer way, is instead of breaking it through the middle, just try to go for sides and break half of it, or if not half of it, just try to leave some out. That's how I go for it, I just break half, then I start stacking until one layer comes out, and then break the other half. It does lose you a little bit of time, but it's just gonna get you those higher points way more consistently. So you're gonna get up to 32,000, 34,000, just that much quicker, alright? Just trust me, go for it. If you're new to this, do what I do. Just break half of it, then start stacking, then break the other half, and then keep going as fast as possible, stacking those, and then breaking them all, obviously, at the end. Now, step 4 is fully destroy one of the colors and leave one color before finishing. Now for this one is all you gotta do after finishing and you're left with one color, do stack, even if it's like 3-4 seconds left, try to go for that last clear board kill for them to pop up one more layer, and it's only gonna be 1,000 or 2,000 points, but the reason is for that after you reach a certain level and after you start getting 24 or 20,000 consistently, the game will put you up with people who also get that consistently, so your skill level will be higher, and at that point people will be, it's gonna be a really close game, so it's only gonna be 100 difference or 90 points difference, it's gonna be get crazy close. So trust me on this, it is worth to like sacrifice, just risk it, risk that 1 second to clear the entire board with that one extra 1,000 points that just might put you over the edge of against other players. Now thank you guys so much for watching, I hope you enjoyed and I hope it helped. Please do make sure to check out my other videos on how to play Bubble Clash, what to do and what not to do. I have many more, I'll link a playlist down below, and if there aren't any many more, there are more to come, trust me on this. I'm hard in the works on making more videos, and if you watch them all, it'll make you way better at Bubble Clash. please do leave in the comments below on what better strategies or what you do, how you play Bubble Cash, and I'll read them and check them out. Please make sure to like and subscribe, it really helps a lot. It only takes you 5 seconds, it helps a lot with the channel. And please do use my promo code, because we both get $1, and that's, I mean, it's just free money, you know? I can't say no to that. And thank you guys so much for watching, and see you next time.